Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over a layered workflow using the Maya Mila material, which is new in Maya 2015. So let's get started. There's been a bunch of layered workflows that have been used for the last several years. One, in terms of using the Maya Mia material, there is one where you can hook up the material X into different surface shaders and then drop them into a layered shader, and that seems to work pretty well. There's another one using the color mix node. There's other useful reading that I would recommend using the Maya help docs. There's a recommended mental ray for Maya shaders help doc, and then there's also the Mia material help doc. Let me quickly just flip to those. Those open. Here's the recommended mental ray for Maya shaders help doc, and it's pretty short, but it goes over some recommendations for what some of these different shaders are for. And then also what's some of my students had some questions about the different bump mapping parameters that are listed. There's a overall bump, and I mean, it's really useful to read this whole doc, but it's pretty long, but it's a good reference. And this is even the old one that I just grabbed offline. Let's see what else. There's also a Mental Ray blog that's really useful. And that within the Mental Ray blog, there's a fairly a post that came out in April that goes over, it discusses a lot of the Mila material and a workflow. So, all right, let me go back to my PowerPoint. And in terms of the workflow that I'm going to be using, I'm going to be going off of the color masking workflow that I presented in my last video, with one sort of minor addendum or difference in Photoshop. I've got that open. I mean, I sort of made some adjustments. I made a new object that's a little bit faster, less materials. Also, one thing to point out too that I put my layers inside of folders inside of Photoshop, and that will help Maya identify the PSD layers. So, okay, so let's keep going. In terms of the thought process, the idea is that and for a long time, it's been known that the fewer materials that you have in your scene, the better. Basically, there's the switch node that's inside of Maya that's been in there forever, which will allow you to use less shaders in order to achieve multiple objects, multiple looks. Also, we're sort of moving into the realm of physically based materials, which have a balanced energy input and output. And so with the implementation of the Mila material, that takes us one step closer to this, where we're sort of using less materials, but then when we're using physically based materials, that's where it gets a little bit complicated in terms of saving rendering time. And that's sort of the promise that Mila material will sort of allow you to save render time. And here's the sort of thought process that I went through. Basically, you can have weighted layers in the Mila material where you have, several different specific types of materials, and they're discrete. Where you can also like go in with the Mila materials, you can have mixed materials within one material. And as well as other materials. And you can have different layers for refraction and different layers for incandescence and transparency. But in terms of like layering it all up, then you could sort of put a wrapper on top of everything, and you could sort of go towards a top material mask. And that material mask could be rust or dirt. And this could be sort of an idea for how you might want to think about your, developing your materials. So, I mean, obviously, it would be more efficient if you could break your materials into different layers of reflectivity and work into that. Whereas, I think I'm going to do for this example, I'm going to show sort of a potentially more efficient workflow, and then I'm going to show I have, several separate materials that I'm going to mix all together. All right, so let's get into that right now. Okay, so here's the object that I've made, and I've got it built and layered, and I've got it. Here's the sort of breakout. So the basic breakout that I did or that I baked out from Maya looked like this, and using that similar workflow that I did in the last video. And then I'm going to use a Miele material. So let's put a Miele on top of that. This will be Miele 1. And we can put in, I've basically got four different layers. I've got red, green, blue, and cyan. So let's choose a weighted layer. And just to go over this, the basics are, that you can have a mix of reflectivity. These are refraction right in here. And then there's also transparency. And then there's subsurface scattering and incandescence. So I'm going to choose just a basic diffuse. And this mix node will also allow you to mix within the material itself. First I'll choose diffuse. I'll do, and also in terms of the way the layers would work, you could also choose Fresnel, which would use a Fresnel-based fall off. Meaning the facing ratio would affect the fall off. But for this example, I'm just going to choose a simple weighted material for all of these. So we'll choose a glossy reflection. We'll do glossy reflection for the rest of them. I thought about doing additional, I did a practice one where I did an additional transparency mixed material, but that just sort of overcomplicated things. But if you're in my class, if you're taking my class, you can certainly ask me about that. All right. So now I imported my file texture, my PSD, and then I broke it out into separate layers. And each layer now has, I can drop down to that layer. So I named them red, green, blue, cyan. And so basically, I'm going to drop those masks into the Miele 1 material that we've just made. So let's do that. So we've got red, and I'll drop that into the weight parameter. Red, green, blue, and cyan. Okay, and we could sort of just recolor these. And here's something that's, let's see. We'll do something that's just to show that this is all working. Okay, and let's give that a quick render. Okay, so that rendered out just fine. We've got the different masks look like they're working fine, and we've got this was the diffuse only, and then the others had glossy built into it, so it looks a little bit like a Christmas ornament right now. Let's now go in and choose a different workflow. We're actually dropping in Mia X materials into each of those layers. And the Mia X materials that I prepared previous to recording this are these different layers. Let's see. So I have the one that's sort of gold looking, one that might have a couple that are sort of ceramic glazed looks with a bump map. This is a more matte wicker look and basic ceramic look, I would say. All right, so but let's drop these all into the layers as materials themselves. So within the, let's go into the the Mia. We could do Mia Material 1 or Mia 2. If you go into the second tab here, you can actually see that we've got the potential for different shaders that could be dropped in. So I could just break these all and add in new ones, or well, let's just give that a try. So in terms of overriding, so that was the plan was red. Let's go for Mia green, blue, and cyan. Okay, and now let's re-render. Okay, it looks like it worked out just great. So, this is basically an overall potential workflow where we're using the, you can sort of reduce your number of steps in terms of the previous workflow where you're using surface shaders in order to get this to work correctly. And I think that, there's room for further exploration and efficiencies in terms of breaking down your materials further. But here's a this is a good start to a workflow. I look forward to any comments people would want to post, and thanks so much for watching. All right, see you in the next video.